you start off with everything's like this deal now as a lease option is really exciting, and there's like £4,000 in, and there's less than £200 a month profit, and it's like, oh, why would anyone not do this stuff? And then you'll do a few of those, and then you'll get some hassle, and then it'll be like, this shit ain't worth it. And then you'll do like bigger, you might do a 3 or 4 bed HMO, and then you'll get to a point where you've got 10 HMOs or this guy who's got that. And it gets, you get bored of stuff and tired of the hassle, and your finances change and your age changes and your priorities change. So the difference between the blind avon vendor, who's like probably a distressed seller of his own property or her own property, versus the landlord Wayne is dealing with, is that the landlord Wayne is dealing with is kind of at the end of his property journey. And by the way, this cycle is lessened by doing it in a group. I'm talking about people who do it on their own. Like, so my portfolio, the thought of doing another deal now is just like, oh, like it's gonna have to be a big one to make it worth it. So unless it's Courthouse Street, an 8-bed HMO with a flat, or Victoria Avenue, you know, 4-bed holiday let with another flat, unless it's that big, I don't even wanna look. So I don't even want to leave this house when the extension's done, unless the house is bigger and it's more work than this one. So I said to Owen, I don't really want to move. And he went, what about this one? And I went, oh yeah, I'd move there. So it's like, it's all relative, but over time, the deals get less attractive. The difference between you doing a lease option with that guy is that he's an experienced landlord. He's not in distress. You're not playing on anyone's vulnerabilities. Wayne's genuinely helping out someone who's just like, I don't want to deal with this shit anymore, and I totally get that. I remember my rental agent saying to me, yeah, we don't manage your properties now, but one day you'll come back. Because I was like, Di, why do you always help me out so much? He was like, you'll come back. You've got 18 properties, you'll come back. And I'm like, no, I won't. It's going to cost me a couple of grand a month for you to manage them when I could just take the calls. I'm already getting there. Sarah, I already pay you, right, to do the stuff. Because I'm like, I don't want to deal with that hassle anymore. And the difference is Wayne's dealing with someone in that situation who's not doing it out of desperation. The blind avon deal, the guy's in some form of distress. And that's a wholly different lease option. Because I don't want to like completely down lease options. I'm not saying they're bad, but there's different ways of doing them.
Yeah.
And Wayne's one is wholly different to that one. And vice versa, and it's bigger cash flowing, right? It works way better, all the rest of it. It's a win. It's a genuine win-win for everyone. I suspect the blind avon one, it's a very big win for the sourcer. It's kind of okay for you guys, and it's probably pretty sucky for the vendor. It's not really a win-win-win. And I suspect over the 5 years, it won't be a win for you either.